Hello everyone. Today, I will be talking about building a community. What are the main challenges you will be facing, but also what great achievement you can look for. And of course, some tips I learned for the past 2 years about building a community inside the company I'm part of. I'm Jean Burelier. I'm a principal engineer at Euler Hermes. And as you can expect from this talk, I'm also really passionate about building communities, sharing and mentoring people from the company, but also in Meetup or other parts. You can find me pretty much everywhere on the internet with the nickname Cheplu, except on Twitter, you will find me with the Cheplu nickname. So let's go. What is a community? So first of all, you will find a lot of definition of community, but for me, it's really just a group of people which share a common interest in any kind of topic or subject. So with this small definition, you can already see that a lot, you are part of a lot of communities. Your family and friends, it's a community. Maybe you are part of some club, like a sport club or a book club, or I don't know which kind of club. Maybe you play online with friends or with people you don't even know, but you are on the same team, on the same guild. It's also a community. Your team is a community. You work with your team every day, 8 hours a day. It's a community. And also the people of these conferences, you are all part of the same, let's say, community, let's say Node.js community. So that's great. You are already part of a lot of community. But I think it's really like one big community here. It's really a company community. And that's really what I want to address. So first, let's see what's the main value of having this kind of, at least for me, tech community inside a company, but it can be even broader inside the company. What are the main challenges you will face when building it? What kind of accomplishment you can look for, and some, like I said, some tips and some stuff I learned along the way. First of all, really for me, when arriving at Euler Hermes a bit more than 2 years ago, it was really, I was really keen to improve and to build this kind of community. It was one of my main tasks to improve the communication and the collaboration between every people working in the company, from multiple people in the same country to also developer and software engineer in other country. How can we work together to build something better? It was also not just technical to share code and feedback like that, but it was also to allow people to present, to be able to show what they know, what they want to share with other people. So it was also this part of having people who are willing to share and to present stuff to help them to do that. And of course, also with this kind of global community, how can we improve the IT domain inside Euler Hermes to build projects across team, build reusable projects, like, I don't know, maybe work on the same security to find and to build some security stuff, but also to create maybe for the front-end part, a design system for everyone to use and where everyone can just collaborate. So the main challenges, it will depend on the size of the company, or the mindset of the company, maybe how old is the company. But mostly the main challenges I was really facing was, first, you have to demonstrate why it's great for the company. What are the advantages for the company to have this kind of structure, to have this community inside? Because it takes time. So time is just money for people. You also need to find speaker if you want to present. You cannot be the only one to give a talk, to present something. You have to find other people. And it's really hard to find people. A lot of people want to share, but a lot of people are also shy to share. So you have to help them, to mentor them, and also just basically to find them. It's also a question of time and organization. Because when you try to build a community with maybe 10 people of the same team, it's quite easy. If you are working with more than 100 people across even multiple continents, it's really hard to organize a good slot time for everyone to share and to be present. And with this global pandemic, it was also really hard, or it was a big change from moving to on-site meeting to online and to everything use internet to communicate and stuff like that. It was, let's say, a hard change. So for us, really, the first step I took and we all took, it's really to foster some kind of regular on-site meeting. Let's call it a guild. Just a way for people to share, to show on what they are working on, some issues they want, maybe feedback from other people, from other team, and just to collaborate together to share what they do, what they want to do, and how we can improve stuff. You also need to have a dedicated solution to just exchange and share. I'm not really talking about just Zoom or Hangout to speak online, but really to have a way to maybe share code so you can use the same solution as a company, but also a way to discuss every day on every kind of topic. So for us, it was basically using Slack, like a lot of people. You also have, for people who are already capable of talking and presenting, it's really great to try to find time with them to mentor new people, new speaker who want to learn and to present stuff. So it's a really a great part and it can take a lot of time. And of course, one of the hardest parts was to really be able to include people from all the team, because we were working also on project use across teams. So for me, it was really making sense that everyone, or at least we have a vision of people from every team that can just come and bring that feedback, how we can evolve, if it's useful or not. So it's really to have a global part. Currently, we are only mostly working with IT people, but it could be also really great to open that to other people in other departments, like financial, business, or stuff like that. Really depend on the company. So after 2 years, this is a list of the main accomplishments we did. So I'm really proud of that, because from not having this kind of community, 2 years later, now we have a collaboration between more than 15 teams and 100 software engineer, or let's say engineer, because we have also security and cloud engineer working with us. So it's really great to have this kind of collaboration. We held almost 2 meetups a year, 2 internal meetups a month. it's also way easier for us to have a better overview of every teams, of what all the team are doing and how we can help them and how each team can help each other. We have a better way to communicate, a faster way to communicate between everyone. So that's great. We also work to have a standardization between all teams. So mostly to just have the same way to code, to try to reuse the same code. And this lead to have to know that we have more than 10 shared projects. They can go to, like I said a bit earlier, about a design system, but also a same list of library we use, tracing, security, stuff like that. So that's really great. We also spend a lot of time mentoring new speakers. So now we have maybe between 5 and 10 speakers, so that's really great for us. And also to bring this kind of mentality of continuous improvement for everyone. So that's really great. And I'm really happy to that. Some tips really fast, because it's almost the end. Like I said, mentor people who are willing to share and present. People can be shy, so try to just be with them and work with them to have more feedback and more people who want to talk and who will talk. At first, it's always hard to just begin something like that. So bring interesting topics that other people would like to work on. Maybe on security issue, maybe on tracing issue, maybe on how we can standardize stuff across all people using the same technology. Can be a lot of stuff on multiple subjects. Try multiple ways to animate and to have a guild, because some people are really willing to share and to present, to talk, but some people don't really want that. They want to write article, to maybe write a tutorial or stuff like that. So try to not just focus on one way to have this community working, but in a lot of ways. Support newcomer. Also, it's always hard to when people arrived in a company and you have a lot of people, multiple teams. So try to, this community and this guild system is also a great way to have newcomer integrate faster and I think better in the company. And one stuff I learned with this pandemic is really record the session. We weren't recording the session before it, Now we are recording everything, and it's really a great change. It's a lot of people from other time zones or which for any reason weren't able to attend just to rewatch it. So really record the session. It's maybe the best tip on the list. So yeah, that's all for me. It was quite fast. So thank you everyone. I hope you will enjoy the conference, and you can find me on the internet. Come talk to me about community, what maybe challenges you are facing and where you want to improve it. So yeah, it would be really great to talk to you. Enjoy the conference. Bye.